People get fired up over politics. Issues like abortion, immigration, sexism, feminism, fascism, socialism. There's all these isms to get fired up about. And I brushed up against talking about some of these issues right here on this YouTube channel. But I've never seen people get so activated, so defensive, and so angry as in the response to a video I made called Why You Should Never Use a Microwave. I posted this video on June 7th of 2018, almost a year ago, and the purpose was to express my opinion on microwaves. I don't use microwaves. I don't like to eat food that's been microwaved, so I made my video to share my opinion and some scientific findings on microwaves showing that it's not the healthiest option for cooking your food. And I mentioned that they are disgusting. Keep in mind that I've never advocated for microwaves to be banned, and I also don't believe that using a microwave is going to instantly kill you. And I didn't even come close to making that assertion in that original video. I do think it's an interesting discussion to talk about whether microwaves are bad for you or not, but let's just put all that to the side for the moment. What is even more interesting to me right now is the response I received for sharing just the idea that microwaves might not be the healthiest thing for you. People were very upset and also very defensive over the mere notion that microwave use was being challenged. I thought this was very interesting, and it prompted me to start thinking about why would people be this defensive over microwaves? It just seems like such a random topic to receive such a significant response. So I gave it some thought, and I started to see a connection between microwaves and family structure. So bear with me until you can see where I'm going with this. Okay, I want you to picture in your mind what you see as the image of an ideal family. What is your idea of a good functioning family? What do you see? What I see is a family that is strong and harmonious, and you've got mom, and you got dad, and you got the kids, and the gender roles are more on the traditional side, and eating food together is important, and it's a time for all the family members to come together and spend some quality time together, and perhaps even work together in the preparation of the meal. One thing I don't see in that ideal image is a microwave because there's no need to artificially speed up the cooking process because the cooking of the food and the time and the love and the care that is put into that task is part of spending time together. So through everyone wanting the best for the family, that ritual is actually a part of their lives that adds value and strength to the family unit and the quality of their relationships. Now, when I was growing up, my parents got divorced when I was 11. I lived with just my dad from that point until I moved out. And we ate a lot of microwave dinners. You go to the store, you throw them in the basket, you get home, you throw them in the microwave. And I believe this is a symptom, a consequence of the fact that we didn't have the full balance of the family there. And so we both lost the motivation to take that extra step to make a full meal every night. Because there was an absence of our family balance and harmony, we lost that motivation and ended up relying on the convenience of the microwave, essentially out of laziness, which could be seen as a symptom resulting from the emotional fallout from my parents' divorce. So, I propose that the significant response and outrage to my video on microwaves in the urgent defense of microwaves is in fact an unconscious denial of the unfortunate reality that some of these people grew up with as children. My theory is that the microwave unconsciously represents their failing mother or father because of the memory and the role it played in their painful childhood, which they've sealed away deep in their mind behind a shield of bitterness. So let's say you had a single parent who didn't have time to make real food, or you had parents that weren't around, or who just had unhealthy habits or behaviors, or you lived in a household where as a child you were somewhat neglected. Perhaps left alone, perhaps unloved, chances are you weren't sitting down to a full meal prepared with love every night. So I'm seeing the microwave as a symbol of that less than perfect childhood, that mom that didn't love you enough, the dad that wasn't around, or... So when I attacked the microwave, symbolically, I was making some viewers face the shortcomings of their childhood and the underlying fear confronting all those repressed emotions associated with the reality that they just didn't receive enough love as a child. And many instinctively defended the microwave, even though microwaves are gross, might cause health problems, and they make food taste like garbage. And even if you zoom out even further, you'll see the microwave is actually a symptom of the breakdown of the family unit, because the microwave answered the necessity for overworked single parents, families that neglect spending quality time together, and the increase of single people. Keep in mind, we're in the age of dating apps surging in popularity, which promote temporary, meaningless relationships, and we're in the age where marriage rates and reproductive rates are in decline. So we can always debate how many vitamins are subtracted from different ways of cooking foods and all these conflicting science reports on microwaves, but I really do think there's a symbolic significance of the microwave here, and I see it as a representation of the neglect of cultivating meaningful relationships and the erosion of our ability to stop and enjoy simple tasks together in life with the people we care the most about. So in summary, we're looking at a Freudian type of thing going on here, I think. People got pissed when they saw my microwave video, but they were actually mad because subconsciously they interpreted my video as an attack on their lazy mother, who they've never forgiven for neglecting them throughout their crappy childhood. What do you think of my theory? Did you use a microwave growing up? I would love to dig deeper into this. So let me know what you think in the comments.
Hello, I'm Jesus Christ, and I'm here with an important message about my favorite band, Dream Machine. They're currently working on their third album, but they need your help to make it happen. Matthew and Doris Melton played me some of the new demos, and it's already sounding heavenly. So, if you don't want to go to hell, you should consider joining their cause by donating to them on Patreon. Link in the description.